Okay, this video is going to be about finding the slope of a line when you're given 2 points. So, we want the slope, and remember sometimes the slope is indicated with the letter M. I have no idea why they chose M. And the slope is a way of expressing how high up or down we go from one point to another, compared to how far over from left to right we go from the first point to the second point. And sometimes this is expressed as rise over run. In other words, how far you rise from one point to another and how far over you run from the left to the right. So let's look at 2 points and see how this works. Okay, so let's take the points 1, 2 and 4, 3. And so we can visualize this. Let's get a bit of a graph. 1, 2, 3, 4. So there's my x-axis. And here's my y-axis. 1, 2, 3. Let's put in some numbers. I'm just going to use the positive numbers, because all we're doing is dealing with positive numbers. And this point, 1, 2, well, that would be, let's see, 1 and 2, so that would be right here. That's 1, 2. And the second point, 4, 3, so I've got a 4 here and a 3, so I'm probably about here. And what we want to do is figure out, if we drew a line through those 2 points, what would the slope of the line be? Okay, so we want to know, let's write our equation. Let's just write that m, or slope, equals the rise over the run. So I want to find out, from here to here, how much do I rise? Well, remember, rise is a vertical measure. We're talking about going up and down. And we've gone from this point, which has a y value of 2. Let's write y over there. And y tells me how high up or down I am. So it's got a y value of 2. And I'm going over to this point where the y value is 3. So I've gone from 2 to 3. And if I want to think in terms of how far is that? Well, I know what it is, but if I want to do it formally, I could take the 3, I'll take the 3, and subtract 2. Okay, so let's take the 3 and subtract 2. And then I want to find out, so that's my rise, and then I want to find out how far I'm moving from the left to the right, how far I'm running from here, and over here, my x value is 1, and I want to go to here, where my x value is 4. So I've gone from 1 to 4, and the way to find out how far that is would be to take the 4 and subtract the 1. So I'll take the 4 and subtract the 1. And now if I do the subtraction in the numerator and denominator of this fraction, I'll get 3 minus 2 is 1, and 4 minus 1 is 3. So this is going to be my slope. Now, let's look at this in a more general way so we can get a formula out of it. So this 1, 2 is an ordered pair, and it's got an x and a y. And this 4, 3 is also an ordered pair, and the first number is an x and the second number is a y. In order to tell the difference between this x and this x, let's call this x1 and call this x2. And let's call this y1 and call this y2. Now, what I did when I wanted to find the rise was, you remember, I took this 3 and subtracted 2. So in other words, I took the y2 and subtracted the y1. So another way to talk about the slope would be to say that the rise is y2 minus y sub 1. And when I wanted to get the run, the denominator for this fraction, I took the 4 and subtracted 1, which is the same as saying I took the x sub 2 and subtracted x sub 1, x sub 2 minus x sub 1. So this then is going to be the general formula for my slope. Now, once you understand this general formula, you don't have to write the whole graph anymore. We can do it. Let's fix that. We can do it just from the ordered pair. So let's start again. Here's my formula. Slope equals y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. And my ordered pair, let's write that again, was 1 comma 2 and 4 comma 3. And I can write in x sub 1, y sub 1, x sub 2, y sub 2. And I'm just going to plug these things in. So y sub 2 was 3. Y sub 1 is 2. And then I've got x sub 2, which is 4, and x sub 1, which is 1. And if I do my subtraction, I'll get 3 minus 2 is 1, and 4 minus 1 is 3. And that's the same answer I got before. So in other words, once I know this formula, m, or slope, equals y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1, all I have to do is identify my x's and y's, plug them in, and I'll get the slope. Now, one quick thing. Let's say I'd identified them differently. Let's say, for instance, that I had called this x sub 1 and this y sub 1, and I called this x sub 2 and y sub 2. Well, we're going to see it doesn't make a difference. Okay, so let's get rid of this and do it with the numbers reversed. So now I've got y sub 2 is 2 minus y sub 1, which is 3. X sub 2 is 1 minus x sub 1, which is 4. 2 minus 3 is negative 1. 1 minus 4 is negative 3. Negative 1 over negative 3 is the same as 1/3. So I still get the same answer. Okay? So bottom line is this. You start out with a pair of coordinates, two ordered pairs. You take one of them and you label them x sub 1, y sub 1. It doesn't matter which one you call x sub 1, which one, and y sub 1. You take the other one and label that as x sub 2, y sub 2. You take your formula, plug in your y sub 2 minus y sub 1, your denominator x sub 2 minus x sub 1, carry out your arithmetic, and you'll have the slope of the line. That's it. Take care for now. I'll see you next time.